Speaking of the Korean War, during this past few weeks, there has been much talk about this very hard-fought battle on the Cheongseong Lake, Chosun Lake, and a Chinese movie was made about this, and history was dug out about what happened, and American journalists were filming that movie, filming during that battle. Also, their footage has also came out. Huge discussion. Have you heard about this? Have you really seen the, you know, heard about this? What are your comments? I would really be interested in find out.
Well, fascinated by the Korean War. It's the forgotten war. Because there wasn't that much media back then, and the American forces controlled the media much better than they were able to in Vietnam. So it was a bloody, bloody, ridiculous war, and unnecessary because essentially it came out of the fear of communism. We were told that Stalin was behind the Russian Stalin was behind the invasion of South Korea, and we went in there thinking we were fighting communism. And then when Douglas MacArthur moved up north, the general, he was talking repeatedly about bombing China. He was talking about dropping nuclear bomb on China, atomic bomb. So and that's when the Chinese started to move in, and they came into the war in a big way, and that battle you're talking about was part of that winter of 1950-51 when the American forces retreated into the south again, and it was a bloody, bloody war. The Chinese lost a million men at least in that campaign,
right,
and
right.
The Americans were not prepared for this kind of warfare, and it ended up in a, as you know, as a stalemate. Two years, three years later, and we didn't learn anything from it. It was just a fight against communism, and in which we did the same thing we did in Vietnam, but even worse. We bombed the South and we bombed the North. Talking about killing civilians, this was a huge, so many civilians were killed. People know about the North because we flattened it, but essentially they don't know about the South. We also flattened a lot of areas
yeah.
in the South.
Let's fast forward to present day. President Joe Biden, after he upon withdrawing from Afghanistan, basically he said the United States needs to stop the damage in Afghanistan to concentrate on major power competition. And he with that he means China. And he's also, and there's this hyped talk about, you know, democracy or like-minded countries versus authoritarian regimes such as China. So do you think the shadows of that kind of idea that have been haunting the United States and other parts of the is still here with us?
For several years, the last 7-8 years, it was Russia. And certainly in the last 2 years of Trump, it was China. China was always in the news and it was the bad guy. And it's very childish what's going on, but the United States has control over its news, and often its news is propaganda. So we started to hear about the Chinese and Huawei was a bad guy and 5G was going to be taken over by the Chinese. This was, again, the same thing as the mind warfare of the 1950s, where communism was going to take over. Now it's 5G. Obviously China, same thing with the labor system in Xinjiang.
Yeah.
They were making all these accusations about genocide, which was insane because there was no proof of it. It was propaganda. And they were selling, and the Christians too. I mean, everything that the United States could throw on the fire. They promised to send more troops to Asia. They've armed the Australians. They're trying to arm the Vietnamese and so forth, and the Filipinos. There's definitely a move to back to the Pacific. Hillary Clinton talked about it.
Right.
Obama talked about it, but we were always distracted by the Middle East. And now there's talk about it, and the people of the United States are subjected again to propaganda. And who knows what's going to happen.